Well, folks, time for a quick update on the Land Rover. Got the center console connected up yesterday. Put my dash tray in, which was interesting, trying to fiddle that into place. But we got there. I've got a trim strip to put on there. That's the last job to do. Put this cover back. Get that out of the way. I've repaired this, which all the connections inside looked a bit dodgy, so the actual solder joints are okay, but they don't look very strong, so I've strapped up the cable so they can't wander. So the idea is nothing can short out then. The connections for those come up here, inline fuse, a couple of bullet connectors, and that will just float about in that tray so I can get to the fuse and disconnect it quickly, and that will go under there and connect onto the back there. But there's a proper insulator there this time, so that's okay. Let's make do, and then one pointed out, this is not a good idea having it this way up, so I need to get some more of these covers so that if I'm not using it, it's safe. Tested the radio, that works fine. Draws very little current as well, which is great. Fuse box connected. I'm just waiting on the bulbs from Auto Sparks. Unfortunately, they didn't get those out to me last week, so they're a special capless type. Also finished connecting up the dashboard, but I'll have to show you some pictures of that so you can see what's there. I'll just open the bonnet, show you what I've been doing under there. Oh, and by the way, I've tested the lighting circuits today. Have to have the engine running for the rest, like the heater, windscreen wash and all that. But the lighting stuff does all work. Haven't checked the brake light yet, so that's the next thing. I used to sort those plugs out today. I cut off the unwanted terminals, so that's all connected up okay now. Couple of bullets pushed in those ones, which are fine. Strapped all that up. And I've a couple of unwanted ends there for kit that my Land Rover hasn't got, so I'll strap them up as well. So we're getting there now. It's a choke warning light. The new battery tray, or the cleaned up one rather. Well, I've been doing a bit of work under the bonnet today on these plugs. There was an extra pin there and an extra one around there, so I've cut those off. So the wires are still safely terminated, but nothing can short on those should they become live. So that's the original plug, and it all lines up. Those two have connected in there okay, and that plug's okay as well, and I've just tied all that up, keep it out of the way. Had an extra plug there for a kit that my Land Rover hasn't got, so I strapped it all up, insulated it. It's choke warning light there, and it's the stop switch for the brakes. The battery tray back. Also, someone's run a separate line to the starter solenoid, which is down there, and that goes to the relay in the centre console, but I might be able to bypass that, so I'm going to get it running with that, and then once I know that works, I'll try this line, which I think is the right one. Right. Another thing I got today is a spare gearbox and transfer box for WRD. A fellow Land Rover nut and stationary engine enthusiast came all the way down from Suffolk to Kent and dropped this off for me in an old diesel Land Rover. Series 2 transfer case, Series 3 gearbox and Series 2 bell housing. Plan is to rebuild it, get it good, and then transplant this into my truck in place of the current gearbox and transfer box. That's a series 2 bell housing, I'm told, so I'd have to change that. Series 3 gearbox, so that'll be okay, and the transfer box, I'm told, remain the same. Usual Land Rover working tolerances. So it'll be, you know, new bearings, probably synchro hubs and springs, that sort of thing. Selectors all seem to work okay though. I think that's the reverse gate. Definitely needs a rebuild. That's where the high-low range lever connects on, and that goes all the way through that case into there. And that's the two-wheel drive or four-wheel drive selector for high range. Looks promising in there though. Seen much worse. If you had an overdrive, that's where that would be fitted. I would quite like to fit overdrive, might increase my cruising speed a bit. So there you have it. Plan is to rebuild that and maybe get it put in next winter. Anyway, for what it cost me, I couldn't say no. So thanks very much to Andrew for delivering that. And I'll update you again on the electric soon. It might even be tomorrow that I actually turn the key, start the engine for the first time off the rewire. We'll see what happens. Anyway, thanks for watching.